figure this out now. Ish. If you're new here, hi, I'm Anusha. I'm a musician and a vlogger, apparently. This is an impromptu video. This is something I was not planning to do today. I was planning on editing some photos, writing a song, and then getting some like admin stuff done. But I've come here to complain again. So, I have been ill. If you have missed my past few videos, I have been quite sick. I am going to get into what I think it is later, but all we need to know right now is I have been quite sick. You know, when you're sick, you obviously go to the hospital, you go to the GP, you know, you try and figure things out. And that's what I've been trying to do. Yeah, I've been trying to figure out what has been going on, been trying to figure out like if it's life threatening or not. It's not, thank God, but it might be. Again, we'll get to that later. God, this really is turning into a rant. I came back from a long trip and I had a really tight chest. And originally I was like, I have a tight chest. Okay. Like, I have heart problems, even though my cardiologist doesn't think so. So I was like, okay, let me just, you know, go to A&E. They'll give me the aspirins. They'll give me whatever and I'll be fine. But they were like, there's nothing wrong with your chest or your heart. You know, I had an x-ray and everything. And I was like, all right, okay. So that down to the trip to the GP. And I'm not going to get into every fucking GP appointment because I've had a billion. But the short version is I have been back and forth between the hospital and the GP for the past 5 months now. Wait, hold on. February, March, April, May, almost June, almost 5 months. And I'm so sick of it. I'm so tired. So basically, like I said, I have a tight chest. I have a tight chest and I don't know what's going on. So I was like, okay, so what's the GP gonna say? Maybe he'll prescribe me some anti-inflammatories or whatever. Nothing. They said, if you have a tight chest, you've got to go to call 111 or go to hospital. So the hospital's telling me to go to the GP. The GP are telling me to go to the hospital. And I'm just there stuck in the middle, like, while you lot are arguing with each other, nobody's helping me, okay? Nobody's figuring out what the fuck the issue is. And mind you, when this started getting really bad was about around April time. And at that time, I was trying to write a fucking song. I was trying to finish the Burden project. I had a zine coming out and I literally could not get out of bed. What the fuck is going on, right? So, again, had more hospital appointments, more GP appointments. And the last time I went to hospital was the bank holiday. It was the bank holiday just before the coronation. And I remember just being sick and tired. I remember saying to the paramedic, like, nobody is going to help me. Nobody is going to figure out what's going on because just I go there, they say you look fine and send me on my way with some form of medication. But the guy said, you know what, you have to go because you have a history of heart issues. You just go, and even if they don't do anything, at least it'll be on your record so that it will be taken more seriously. Which is so sick, because take me seriously when I tell you I'm fucking ill. But anyway. So that time I went to A&E, which was, again, that back holiday, I didn't get taken seriously, if you couldn't guess. And the guy called his supervisor on me, because I refused to leave. I said, I am not leaving here without pain medication. I am sick. The guy calls his supervisor, which I thought was a bit of a bitch move, because sort out yourself, but whatever. But I think he wanted backup, because he saw me as trouble, right? He gets a supervisor, and the supervisor actually looks at me and said, you know what, like, why would I lie about being in pain? You know people do it, but then even if people do lie about being in pain, what's the reason? You know, what's the fucking reason? So he goes to me and he says, well, you know what, if she's in that much pain, we need to prescribe her a short dose of opium. Now was quite a strong drug. And I did not want to be on it. I wanted pain relief, but I didn't want something that was going to whack me out, right? I wanted like an anti-inflammatory, like something similar to naproxen. If you don't know what these are, like, there are anti-inflammatories that like are designed to like relax your body, right? And I was initially looking for those, but then I found out I was allergic to naproxen. So, and also there are some anti-inflammatories called NSAIDs that I can't have. Their next step for them anyway was like, we'll give her opium if it's that severe. And it is that severe. And actually, the opium has been helping. Even though I don't really want to be on opium, it's the only thing that is sorting me out. It's the only thing that is making me feel well. I was on opium and I felt like top of the world, top of the earth, right? I literally felt like I was almost back to normal. The pain was still there because it didn't sort out the problem, but I could get on with life. I recorded Burden. I was able to get the zines out and post them, you know, because that all takes fucking energy. I was able to make these YouTube videos because I had energy. Ultimately, I was better, but they only gave me a very small dosage because they assumed that the GP would then look into this and say, hey, like, what's going on here, you know? And I think that's the issue with the A&E people, like, and it's not to any fault of their own. They assume that the GPs are going to listen to their patients and, you know, they're going to figure out what's going on. But no. About like 2/3 of the GP appointments I've had, I have been lectured about the Hippocratic Oath. I have been threatened by a GP. I have had to write complaints. I've had to like explain what fucking racism is. I have been dismissed so much. And if you have someone in your office or whatever, and they are in distress, the least you can do as a doctor is ask them how they feel. Why are you upset? Is there anything I can do to help? Let's brainstorm. What's interesting is that all these doctors were, in my personal opinion, thinking I'm overreacting or thinking I'm completely wrong, then why not tell me that I'm wrong rather than dismiss me? Why not help me understand what's going on with my own body rather than dismiss me? Why not refer me to something called pain management, which is a specialist service that deals with pain, rather than dismiss me? Rather than just looking gauntly and just being like, well, you look depressed. Or trying to argue with me, which I always win an argument, please don't try me. Rather than actually help. These fucking doctors aren't helping. This is why, for me personally, and as someone who literally like is working in this industry, I am so conflicted when people say save the NHS. Because what has it done for me recently? Really, what has it done for me recently? And I might be the anomaly, but I'm not. So many chronically ill people have so many issues when it comes to the GP. Because they either don't know enough or don't care enough. And it tends to be a bit of both. But the issue is when they don't care enough or when they don't know enough, you put people's lives in danger. You have fucking blood on their hands. This pain, it was so dull. It was minuscule. I was like, oh, like, it's a little bit of a funk. Like, I felt hot, like heartburn. Now it feels like there's a balloon in my liver and it's gonna burst. They let it get that bad because no one has listened to me. No one's attempted to even give me anything. I actually got pain relief from this private service I get from work, which I am so grateful for-ish, because they've not been the most helpful, but they've at least tried. But they're limited in what they do because they can't see me in person. That's the only way I got pain relief. And then actually, when I got, it only took one black doctor to look at me and be like, oh yeah, you've been prescribed this, here's more. And I was able to get on my work day. I only have up to like 8 tablets left of my opium. And after, I don't know what the fuck I'm gonna do. And I don't know why I'm making this video per se, but I think I'm pissed off because, and I shouldn't be pissed off for this reason, but it's affecting my fucking work. Like, I love making music. It takes energy to make music, but I am so grateful that I'm able to make music and sing. I have not been able to sing for the past couple of months. And I am losing my voice because of this pain. And it's not necessarily my voice is gone, but I'm not, like, I'm not practicing enough. And it's getting sorer. And I'm just fuming. I'm fucking fuming. And I think a part of me is making this video to sort of, like, apologise. Or, like, don't make an excuse. Cause it's not really an excuse. But, like, to say, hey, this is why I'm not singing as much. I remember when I was in university, there's this boy, and I'm not dragging you if you see this video, there's a chance that you might watch it. I remember, so I've been doing commentary for the past, like, since 2017. I ain't new to this game. This is just, I'm on a new venture, but, like, I've been talking shit for ages. Oh, thank you, Fridge. Oh, love that for me. Yeah, I've been talking shit for ages, and I remember this boy at my university said to me, I don't understand why, like, I don't understand your Instagram, like, you have singing videos, but you also talk, you also have pretty pictures, like, I don't get it, and I have worked so hard to make people get it. I'm mainly a musician, but I also chat shit. And I like to make sure that people know what I'm going through because I love talking. I love explaining and putting things together and making thought. So, like, I love doing this, but music is my first love. And I don't want people to think that I'm not a musician or that I've given up or that I'm not trying. I'm just being left to be sick. It's almost ironic. I don't think this, I'm using ironic in the right way, but let me continue. It's ironic because burden's about that. Burden is about feeling like you are being left behind or that you're being left to die. And, like, I'm just trying to remember the lyrics off the top of my head. Often landing on words when I don't know what to say. You treat me like a burden, it hurts. It feels like an oxymoron because I lean on words when I don't know what to say. It's just basically me creatively saying that when I'm at a loss for words, I tend to chat shit. When I'm at a loss for words and I don't know what to say and I'm at a loss and I'm almost shocked at the lack of humanity that people have, I start chatting shit. And there's another line which I think is my favourite. Is it shyness or cowardice? Do they intercept? Will you at least mourn the death of me? I won't hold my breath. And that line is basically, are you a dickhead for not standing up for me or not listening to me? Or are you shy and scared and you're like, I don't want to interrogate this, I'm gonna hide? What is it? Or is it both? But regardless of what it is, links to what I said earlier, you're leaving me and people like me to die. At the very least, will you stick up for me once I'm dead? Who knows? Fuck you, Kingfisher Surgery. Deptford Surgery, watch yourself. Again, like I said earlier, I am taking this shit into my own hands. Okay? So, I'm going to get better by force, regardless of if it's a doctor or if it's just me. If it means I have to take my own fucking liver out, fine. Because this is ridiculous. Save the NHS for what? For what? What have you done for me recently? We need to have a really good look at how our medical professionals treat us. Because they tend to treat us like burdens. And it's not on. And I'll end on this. I had one doctor that I wrote a complaint about who was upset about how everything unfolded. Even though he didn't actually apologise. He proper lectured me about the Hippocratic Oath. And said that I can't responsibly give you this medication that I was looking for because I don't have evidence that it would be effective. And I said to him, I'm not just looking for medication, I'm looking for care. Your Hippocratic Oath says that you should care for every patient and try your darndest, even if you don't always get it right, to care for this patient. And very few doctors have done that recently. You're fucking cowards. That's all. I've been Anusha. Thank you, Lyle.